Hello, and welcome to Archives 101, How Archival Records Are Organized and Why. For the purpose of this video, all examples will be taken from the Ryerson University Archives and Special Collections database. We use ATOM, a fairly common database being used by archives all across Canada. Before you start your research, it is important to understand the principles and standards used by Canadian Archives and Special Collections. There are two principles maintained by archives in Canada, and they are provenance and original order. Provenance refers to an individual, family, business, or organization that created or received the items. Records from different origins should be kept separate. For example, in our archives, the records from the Ryerson University's Office of the President would not be mixed together with the records from Ryerson Library. The second principle is that of original order. Some records come into an archives already organized by the record's creator, usually by how they were used. If this is the case, an archive should not reorganize those records according to their wishes, for example, by date, into alphabetical order, or by type of material. That being said, many records have no set order when they are donated, so it is up to the archives to arrange and describe them in a way that is most logical in relation to the materials in question. For example, records from a photographer's studio might be best organized by date, or by subject, or by job number. Next, we are going to look at archival standards. Canadian archives traditionally use RAD, the Rules for Archival Description. RAD informs the archives on how to organize, while still respecting provenance and original order, its records and what types of information should be included in the description. This means no matter what type of database you might be searching in, the way the records are organized and the type of information recorded will be similar. How are archival records organized? Archival records were always organized from the general to the specific. The highest level of organization is the full. Some archives may use the term collection or record group. Ryerson University Archives and Special Collections uses RG or record group for university records, F or fonds for records from a single individual, and C or collection for similar items that have been often brought together from multiple sources. Let's take a look at some examples. RG27 is the G. Raymond Chang School of Continuing Education. F 404 is the Jack Layton Fonds. Collection 2005.006 is the Heritage Camera Collection. Within the Fonds, records are further organized into smaller categories. These can include sous-fonds or sub-fonds, series, sub-series, file, file part, item, and component. Different archives organize down to different levels within the fonds, and this can depend on many variables. The variables include staffing, time, size of fonds, and types of materials. For example, if you have large amounts of correspondence, you might organize it down only to a file level. But if you have objects or photographs, you would most likely organize them down to an item level. This chart gives you a better idea of what I talked about in the previous slide. Under fonds, there might be sub or sous-fonds, or you could go right from fonds to series. Some of these series might have sub-series, or go right from series to file, or even series to item. You do not have to use all these levels in the records organization. Archives will utilize the levels that best fit the records they are working with. Looking again at our previous example, RG27, the G. Raymond Chang School of Continuing Education, you can see it has been divided into three sous-fonds. The sous-fonds Programs for the 50+ has been divided into several series. And under the series Life Institute, you can see it has been divided into sub-series, files, and items. F404, the Jack Layton Fonds, has been divided into seven series, three of which you can see here. Series F404.03, Layton Artifacts, Framed Items, and Photographs, has been further divided into items and files. Collection 2005.006, the Heritage Camera Collection, has been divided into 20 series, 10 of which you can see here. In series 2005.006.01, Early Cameras, you can see they've been divided into items for each individual camera. It is important to remember not all archives databases will look exactly the same, but how the records are organized in the Canadian Archives landscape will usually be similar. For more information on archival standards in Canada and the Canadian Council of Archives, please visit their website. Thank you for viewing Archives 101, How Archival Records Are Organized and Why. To learn more about our ATOM database, watch our introductory video, which you can find on the Ryerson Library YouTube channel.